Ooh.
Good job, Gator.
I'm glad he gets
tell me the characters, go.
All right. Well, hi, everybody. This is Friday. That means it's time for your freaking main event. I am your hardcore queen, Carrot. And at any point, if you would like to join us, please dial the number 760-569-7676. Again, it's 760-569-7676. The access code is 200446#. You want to press that pound button. Otherwise, we won't air here, so please press that pound button. Again, it's 200446#. Now, joining me, as always, is my partner in crime, Doug fucking Barrett. What's up?
Hello, everyone. Welcome to It's Friday Night. It's time to do what we do best here in WCC and talk about shit that pisses us off on a weekly basis. But before we can even get to that, of course, we got the big man from Texas, the man who's not only owns Big Red Bubblegum, but I'm storing it for my pack of gum, damn it. Big Red, what is up?
What's going on?
You sound like you're ready to die. Go talk to Albert Wesker. He'll heal you.
Pretty much.
Also joining us tonight, all the way from Hotlanta, a.k.a. the Mushroom Kingdom, he is your WCC ball champion, King Koopa, better known as Gator.
Did you just call me King Koopa? I swear for God. I swear. After the night, y'all would not hear from Doug Barry ever again.
May he rest in peace.
And I know we got one more person joining us tonight, but unfortunately, I'm so drunk, I can't remember his name. Oh, maybe I'm wrong, and it's just the four of us.
No.
Who are you talking about, Doug?
Okay, just Gator.
Somebody was about to speak.
Yeah, who's the fifth one? I can't remember your name.
Hello, Mr.
You got Rode, then you got T5 in here, too.
Oh, T5.
Hi,
T5. Thank
T5.
You.
Hey.
Ooh. And King Koopa being an asshole as usual. All right, Miss Kel, what happened?
You're welcome.
Asshole.
Go fuck a Koopa.
Apparently, there's more than
you're
one asshole in this room tonight.
Go fuck a. Go
thank
fuck
you.
A,
thank you very much. I am an asshole. You can reach me on Twitter at @assholesrush.
Oh
God.
Go fuck a Koopa.
I'm done. That's it.
Oh, God.
You can find him.
Before we get out of fucking hand here.
You can find him in the Kiss My Ass Al.
all right, everybody. Let's get into the shit that Raw was in exactly. It was shit. Except the beginning promo was actually pretty cool. It kicks off with CM Punk, you know, and it's cool because actually, for once, we didn't kick off with a promo by Triple H. Yay! Yeah, whatever.
Take a drink.
He comes.
I'm so.
Punk comes out and he talks about Paul Heyman. He wants a fucking fight. Okay, he made that pretty freaking clear. God damn it, I can't even read my own notes. Curse me for writing in cursive.
Damn it, Tony Schiavone.
You can't read your own handwriting?
Not when I write in cursive, God damn it.
I can't with Tony Schiavone.
Well, Punk ended up getting a match, I believe, with the Big Show, I think I wrote down. I could be wrong. But whatever.
No, he fought Big E Langston.
Oh, yes. I wrote Big, but I didn't say Big E. The fuck is
that? It's because he's black, right? It's because he's black.
I mean, what?
It's in a room full of black people. Of course.
You're welcome again.
Then we had a Los Matador debut. You know those stupid Matadors that's been having promos and Or not promos, more of an introductory shit for like weeks on end. Everyone likes the debut of the Matadors, but B-Face 3MD, I'm not impressed. Okay, it could have been a much better match. Now I can get to the asshole.
Actually,
jobbers against jobbers? I mean, ooh.
Actually, the Matadors, that's not their name, didn't you hear? They changed it to the Flying Jalapenos.
Wow.
Come on, we all know it's just Pimo and Epico. Come on now.
Really, that wasn't funny.
Oh, go to hell. I'm just acting like Jesse the Body's on floor.
Then we had kind of a backstage segment with Orton. Basically, he's being an egotistical dick. Moving on. There was a business proposal. The whole Rhodes family was out, and Triple H and Stephanie, they were all in the ring. And basically, they said, hey, we're going to put your boys in a match with Reigns and Rollins. And Dusty, you're going to be in the corner, and if they lose, none of you can get a job in the WWE ever again. Well, you guys are our assholes, so that's my non-existent dick. And I would just like to say, because I know there's a lot of people that didn't catch it, and I talked about this in the conference, Stephanie, I know you didn't read your poem this time, but come on, watch your words, because she botched a very simple line. Instead of saying, which one of your sons gets their jobs back? She completely mixed it around. Says, which one of your jobs gets your sons back? The fucker is wrong with you. Are you high? Are you drunk? Or I don't know.
I can tell you what happened.
See, she wants the D from Triple H again.
No. She walked away from the almighty Triple H sledgehammer.
That could be it. And then there was a Paul Heyman proposal to Ryback. Okay, I thought that was completely gay. I thought it was going to be something. And then I'm just like, oh, he's just proposing for him to be a Paul Heyman guy. Oh.
Wait, Paul Heyman did work for Ryback?
Jerry Brokeback. Jerry Brokeback.
Well, wait a minute. Since Gabe is working at a gay bar, do you see Ryback or Paul Heyman there right now?
Doug. They would love you over here. Come on.
Sorry. I just got a girlfriend again this week, so no thank you. I love women.
And then the main event wasn't even an actual fucking match. It was just more of a verbal confrontation between Daniel Bryan and Orton, which they did get into some physical action, but again, it wasn't really anything interesting. Basically, Raw was full of promos and barely any matches. Thank you, WWE, for making one of the worst Raws in forever. Fuck you. Sincerely, Kara. What did everyone else think of Raw?
Was that a hate letter?
So politely.
Oh, and you can send hate mail at my email, which will not be disclosed because I don't like hate mail. Fuck you,
Kara. I hate you. I hate you that much at gmail.com.
Kayla doesn't want to do it. Raw sucked. There was nothing good about it. And if you think I'm wrong, you can send all your hate mail to ronbarrett42@yahoo.com, and I'll print it out and I'll use it to make fire so I can have s'mores this weekend.
Okay, what about you, Gator? What did you think about Raw?
Was too
exactly. Good. That's exactly what I thought.
What about you, Red? What about you, Big Bro? I'm sure you got something to say with that big mouth of yours.
Ooh.
Well, Raw wasn't too bad, and I don't know about anybody else, but I'm digging the Epico and Primo's new gimmick.
That theme music is cracking, though.
I like the theme, and that tag team finisher is fire. I like that right there.
I don't like it because Tito Santana ain't with him. That's the only way it could work. You got to bring Santino with him.
No, that'll turn them into a comedy tag team.
Yeah, see, if they think about it, their gimmick, it's more of the Spanish culture than the Mexico.
Or you have somebody come out dressed as Vega from Street Fighter, that will work too, but...
NT5, I don't know if I heard you say if you didn't watch Raw or not, but did you?
Oh, yeah, I watched Raw. It was all right. I liked the debut of Los Matadors. I was kind of on the fence at first. I was with most of everybody, thought it was going to be crap. But then when I found out they had, like, the little dude in the bull costume, I thought that was pretty tight.
You're saying that the bottom line is me, Doug, and Gator are the assholes of Monday Night Raw.
That's okay by me.
Cool.
Wait a minute. How did you and Doug become assholes, too? I mean...
You really haven't listened to the
main
event.
If you called more into the show, you would see how much of assholes we are. Doug,
sorry, I have a job. My name is Black Thomas.
Doug, let's bring it over to you for the main event.
Yeah, the main event, which is the only good thing about wrestling this week, which is very, very disappointing. And it's really sad because the only two people who actually watch the fucking shit is me and Big Red, so... We're the only ones seeing this great entertainment. The first match was Damian Sandow taking on Santino Morelli, the son of Mario and Luigi. Pretty good opening match. Damian Sandow would win with his new finisher move, the Silencer, and thank God he made the Cobra shut the fuck up, which was very nice. Next, it was Mr. Perfect 2.0, Curtis Axel, taking on the... how can I describe this guy? He is so bad in the ring that we would rather have Paulie from the Jersey Shore actually wrestle, a.k.a. Zack Ryder. Zack Ryder got made to what he's always been, a jobbing bitch. He's so bad that I think the Iceman from WCC Ball would be a better wrestler than him. Next, we had the Godwins, I mean the Wyatt family, taking on Primetime, I mean Primetime Players. Yeah, Wyatt family won. Not, that was fucking predictable. But the main event was very great, in my opinion. It was the Dancing Idiots, a.k.a. Tons of Funk, taking on We the People, Antonio Cesaro and Jack Swagger. Antonio Cesaro would pick up the win.
If you ever say it like that again, I'm going to meet you where you live and slap you in the face.
Jack Swagger. Antonio Cesaro picked up the one with the neutralizer, but he also did that big old spin with the legs he did to Botus Clay, who Botus Clay weighs about 400 pounds, or that would be about me and Gator in a tag team match teaming up together. So, Big Red, I know you watched the main event this week. How did you feel about it?
It wasn't bad. I liked it well. I enjoyed the main event this week.
So did I. I probably would say it was the best show this week. Now, Kayla,
you know,
I usually
watch it with you guys, so I'm sorry, but honestly, just from the sounds of it, I would probably say that's probably, again, for like, isn't it the second week in a row, it's the best wrestling show of the goddamn week.
Yep. Gato, now, did you actually watch, or were you too busy trying to work over with Neil Patrick Harris for the week? And no comment for Gator. He's too busy blowing a Yoshi. T5.
What's up?
Did you watch the main event this week?
No, I did not.
Case in point, though, no one cares except for me, Gator, and well, not Gator. Cause
Gator. No, I watched it. It was good.
Oh, it was good. Okay, never mind.
Especially when they threw the flag in the air. I thought that was tight.
Yeah, I forgot about that part. Thank you for reminding me of that. Again, though, get another good main event, which is surprising. The main event is somewhat getting better. I don't know who's the person making the matches, but they're doing a good job. And I will say, I think the only bad match was probably the Primetime Players and the Wyatt family, just because of the fact of that one was predictable. I don't think anyone really thought the PTP would win that match. And that's it for the main event this week. So, Big Red, unfortunately, we have to go back to the Dixie Chain and try not to get a disease from her ass. So, what happened on TNA?
Oh, I really don't want to go back up this, but since we're doing the main event. Okay, I think the main event for TNA was supposed to be Bully Ray and Samoa Joe, but the match never got officially started. Bully Ray just beat the shit out of Joe and was about to power drive him on the concrete until AJ came out of the crowd and stopped him and really saved Joe's ass.
Wow.
You should have just let Samoa Joe get power driving on the damn concrete.
Yep. And then, that's how that ended. I don't know if I want to talk about this last statement. It was just horrible, but...
Yeah, you don't have to mention anything because, come on now, if you can save us from the embarrassment and the shit that it was, it's okay. You're saving a few lives.
Yeah, you'll be saving lives today.
Yeah.
We don't want to kill themselves.
I mean,
they might commit suicide if they hear this.
I guess that's it for the recipe segment because... Yeah, lately TNA has not been popping. It is just, I don't know, it's just stupid right now.
I told you before, you can start writing that DVD, they better start drawing that DVD now.
Pretty soon the TNA recipe is going to turn into, yes, welcome to the history of TNA. I'm your host tonight.
We're going to call it TNA has been cooked.
That'll probably be a lot better to talk about the history than rather what's currently happening in the shit fest that is the sinking ship of TNA.
Back in the day, though, TNA used to be good. It used to actually be better than WWE, but...
And then they brought in Hulk Hogan.
WWE is only going because they're stealing all our stuff. I mean...
Did I say that out loud?
I'm sorry. My bad.
Peter doesn't know the definition of the word sorry.
Mm-mm. Oh, and I heard what you said, Doug. I was inside the club at the time. Sorry, sir.
Go blow a photo.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, and, you know, I am proud to say that I missed the first hour of freaking TNA, and I didn't miss a damn fucking bit.
And just everyone wrestling out there while we're hating on TNA this week, let's just put it like this. The Jacksonville Jaguars will probably get more views in their game this week than TNA got.
I doubt that, because Jacksonville gets blacked out. At least Jacksonville gets blacked out.
I doubt that.
Another blackout tragedy.
It's the one time you won't hear Big Ray say that I'm black.
Well, I think I'll move on to probably the third worst thing in wrestling, a.k.a. fucking SmackDown. Congratulations. And since everyone has forgotten, including me, I have to say, everybody, WCC, everyone in the fucking world, everyone fucking listening, please support your local indie scene, okay? Because they're probably 10 times better than what you're seeing on fucking TV. Congratulations, and you heard it from me first.
I'm sorry, I don't support my local indie scene.
I don't either.
That sucks. Dang.
Well, you guys are losers.
The reason why is because, like, they don't never, by the time they tell me when the promotion is and stuff like that, I've been the main player.
That's not my problem. My problem is the heavyweight champion for my independent area looks like a combination of the Connor from KFC and Brother Love.
Wow.
Anyway, that guy started off with the big crying bitch show. He says, oh, let me see through my actions, and shows fucking clips like we haven't seen them before. And he's like, I'm so ashamed, but you have to understand, I had to do those things, okay? It's my job depending on it. I had my family depend on it. Shut the fuck up. None of us give a fuck about your problems. Kiss my ass. He talks about how he's in a 3-on-1 handicap match because he actually grew a set of balls and wanted to punch Triple H. And then, you know, he decided, oh, my balls are shrunk again. I can't do this. I can't do this. I'm going to, I just can't. So he feels sorry for that. I'm sorry that you shrunk your balls and they must have not been big at all.
If you ever have a problem, if you need money or if you're living on the streets, don't go to Kayla's house because she'll be the first one to shoot you.
Oh, I'm sorry, but I think it's funny how the bitch will be crying.
Supposed to be this big fucking, like, giant, and he's crying.
Like
the
Pillsbury
Doughboy.
He likes the Pillsbury Doughboy.
It's like a fangirl on a TV show when their favorite character dies. That's like me when Dexter ended. Jesus. Anyway, he said, if I'm going to go down, I'm taking the Shield with me. And then Triple H comes out. Yeah. Kim says, you don't have to worry about your mortgage anymore. He holds out this piece of the paper and says, this is your mortgage. You don't owe your mortgage. You owe me. And if, I don't remember his exact words, he just basically said, you won't be living in your house. I will.
Yep, he said that.
And he said, he changed it to a 4-on-1 because basically Big Show was like, you know, I'm this big monster and I'm going to tear them apart, okay? And so he has to add Randy Orton in the match. That doesn't change it.
I have a question. It came into my head when I heard this on the show. If Triple H owns the Big Show's house, does that mean Triple H not only gets to fuck Stephanie McMahon, but he can fuck Big Show's wife and he can have a threesome? You're welcome, everybody. I told everyone this is not going to be a child program tonight.
Oh, my God. Are you kidding me? It's just like caution and advisory, this whole fucking show.
Not every show we do is parental advisory.
Exactly, especially freaking Gator's show, you know? My God.
Oh, that's like watching porn. That's like listening to porn.
Yes. But anyway, RVD had a match with, Fandumbo. Da-da-da, shut the fuck up. No one likes your music. You can't dance with the shit. Get the fuck off my TV. Don't make me block you.
Mark my words. They're going to be turning him face.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't give a shit. He's just someone that's there anyway.
Hey, well, just be honest. You don't like Fandango, right?
I like Johnny Cruz. I just can't stand Fandango. He can get the fuck away and rot in hell for all I care. Please excuse these assholes. They have no taste. They have no taste at all. Anyway, after the match, there's a segment with ADR. And basically, I don't know, was it a rep that gave him, like, a fucking dumpster and said, here's a gift from RVD. Yeah, RVD, you're not sticking around very long. We saw the spoilers. Just say goodbye. And then we had another match, ADR versus Ziggy, and that's the millionth time that we've seen it, so I'm not going to cover that. I'm just going to say that Ziggy didn't win, and Damian Sandow just stood there on commentary. Congratulations. Izzy came out after the Divas match and cut a promo. I thought that was pretty fucking cool. Just saying.
I don't like, I'm sorry, I don't like how she be skipping around. I think it's hot as fuck.
SmackDown debut of the Los Matadors, which was just as much of a fail as last week. Go ahead, express your opinions. I can be an asshole and you can be. It's like playing good cop, bad cop. It's all right.
I liked it. I thought it was decent at best.
I'm just waiting for Rio to know what's going to happen. Jesse Ventura is going to come out and commentate on one of the matches and be like, yep, they're the Flying Jalapenos.
No, I'm waiting for Booker T to call somebody a nigga again. That's what I'm waiting on.
And look at that. They hit the Flying Guacamole as the finisher.
And then we get to the main event match, which was Shield and Orton versus The Big Show, which basically ended in, I don't know if they count it as a DQ or a no contest because he didn't announce a winner. Dean Ambrose brought in a chair, and The Big Show punched it, and then they rang for the bell. Big Show was pretty much attacked by all four of them. The Usos came out, and they took care of Reigns and Rollins, and then, you know, just when you think Orton's going to beat the crap out of Big Show, Daniel Bryan comes out, beats on Orton, gets him in the yes lock. Dean ends up getting him out of that yes lock. But either way, Daniel Bryan's on top. Now, my question is, will it be the same on the pay-per-view? And we'll cover that later.
Yes.
SmackDown, ladies and gentlemen, what do you think? It was shit, but it was all right, I think.
I thought it was decent. It was all right.
Let me ask my dog what he thought of SmackDown. Hey, Roger, what did he think of SmackDown? Yep, he didn't say a damn thing. That's how he feels about it.
It was better than Raw.
It was better than Raw, but, you know, it was still shit. What about you, Red?
It was better than Raw.
No comment.
Damn.
And what about you, Hater?
Gator left.
Gator left. He had to go to work.
No, I said Hater, but okay.
Not sure how much we love Gator.
All right, so I'll bring it over to you, Doug. You tell everyone what we're going to fucking do instead of ROH.
No ROH this week, guys, because there's really no news to talk about. I'll talk about ROH next week. From this point on until the show is over, we're talking about Battleground, which, as me and Kev already discussed on our separate YouTube pages, is going to be the worst pay-per-view of the year. So we're going to go over every match, excluding the pre-show, because, let's be honest, no one watches the pre-show. They're either too busy masturbating or having sex or watching the end of a football game or watching baseball or whatever, so... No one cares about
that. Now, Paul, put your pants up, okay?
You stole my line.
Me, I'll be having sex while watching the last football game.
Oh, God. Anyway, we're skipping over the pre-show matches. No one cares.
I'm watching the pre-show. I'm actually looking forward to this pre-show.
Okay, yes, I know it's Dolph Ziggler versus Damian Sandow, but whoopee. That should be on the paper.
Hey, I'm a Sandow guy. And I'm a Dolph guy.
I am too, but I'm sorry. That should be on the pay-per-view, not AJ versus Pre-Bella. Speaking of the two women, let's talk about that Divas match. AJ Lee taking on Pre-Bella. Who does everyone got in this match?
You know, Doug, I assume that you saw my video, obviously, by your comments.
I'm
going to
take Brie.
I don't give a rat's ass about this match, but I believe I picked AJ for retaining, because honestly, I don't give a shit about the Bellas. I hate the Bellas. They're just freaking supermodels who can't wrestle. So,
we got one for AJ.
AJ
now, T5, you said Pre-Bella. Why?
No, that's Roosevelt. I'm Roosevelt. I picked Free Bella.
Roosevelt, okay. Why did you pick Free Bella?
I think because, all because she said, like, you got to think about it, okay? Look at what AJ said tonight about Bree and Dolph. I mean, Bree and Daniel. You got to think about what she said. She said, okay, you two get married and blah, blah, blah. Congratulations, you're going to get married to the WWE first chewing tin can of blah, blah, blah. You're going to have kids and, you know, you're going to have a goat-looking baby. And then, what did she say? Instead of slapping the kids, she's going to slap the parents. Come on now. That's going to be some rage. That's going to be some shit.
Just because they bring in rage in the match, that doesn't mean they win. Honestly, like, that will make the match a little more interesting, her being more rage because it's been more of a personal level. But at the same time, that doesn't ensure that you're going to win. It just kind of increases the chances a little bit. But come on now. Brie, all she has is her looks. She can't fucking wrestle.
Now, Big Red, who do you got in this one?
I want to say AJ is going to retain, but I think storyline-wise, it'll be Brie.
Damn. And that comes to me, and you know what? Like, Kelly, you watched my picks. I'm going to say it again. I'm taking Brie Bella because I think she'll win it all because, one, she is dating one of the top two. She is about to marry one of the top two guys in Daniel Bryan. And, two, if WWE's pushing Total Divas like we're expecting them to for the next season, it would make sense for them to have the champion on their show. So, the Bella Twins, I'm not a fan of those in the ring. I do agree with Kayla that they're good looking, but they suck in the ring. But, yeah, you know, they're going to probably give Free Bella a vote just to push her, in, you know, for the show. So, unfortunately, I got to go with Free Bella.
Yeah, I think Free Bella
okay,
wins.
When
Free
Bella
reason.
Loses in the end, I can say I told you so to everybody.
Now you won't be saying that. You want to be in your own work, Kira.
Oh God. Well, up next, we got a match that was made tonight, technically, but if you have the WWE app, it was made a few days ago. For the Intercontinental title, Curtis Axel takes on R-Truth. Who do you guys have in this match? This match has no promo work whatsoever going into it.
I'm gonna go with the upset. I'm gonna say Truth for the win.
Damn, I gotta heal this reason.
You know, I want to say Axel, but I said in my video that I don't think R-Truth deserves the chance. But I think, you know, they obviously have been giving more attention to R-Truth, so I think he will win and get, you know, a push with it, and maybe have a feud with Curtis Axel. I mean, because they seem to be having a lot of bad blood, so I definitely have to say R-Truth on this one.
Damn, two for R-Truth. Big Red?
What's up?
Oh, God.
Damn,
sir. Oh, man.
You feel
man.
Me.
Yeah.
You know what? I love Curtis Axel. I love him as champion, but... You know, I gotta steal a line from Big Red here. Always bet on black. I'm gonna pick R-Truth for two reasons. One, as much as I like Curtis Axel, I don't think a lot of the fans do. I think a lot of the fans, when they look at him, they're like, the only reason he's Intercontinental Champion is because of Paul Heyman. Or
and his father.
Champion, yeah. The second thing is, Hell in a Cell is Oso this month in October. I want everyone, if you haven't seen the cover boy yet, go look at the poster for it. It's R-Truth. Wouldn't it, so I'm like, okay, if R-Truth's the poster boy and R-Truth's got a nice title match, wouldn't it make sense for the poster boy to have a title going into the pay-per-view or not at the end of October? So,
well, I never thought of it under that aspect, but I'm there, man.
So I'm going to pick R-Truth just for those two reasons. I hope I'm wrong. This is one of the few matches I hope I'm wrong on, but I just feel like I'm not. I just feel like Curtis Axel is going to drop the belt. We have no face champions right now, so somebody, one of the heroes is going to have to drop the belt. It's most likely going to be Axel, unfortunately.
But he hasn't even defended. He really hasn't defended it since he gotten the thing.
I think he's only defended it like what, once or twice, and that, and then both times it was against Kofi.
I think he defended the last only defense I remember was that what, Night of Champions.
Yeah, against Kofi. I think Axel's gonna drop, unfortunately. Next, in this match, I got to be honest, I don't think it's the end of the feud. It's CM Punk versus the Rye Bitch. Who does everyone have in this one?
Now, I don't remember the exact person I picked, but what I do remember is I said, I don't give a single fuck about this match. I love CM Punk. He's one of the best in the fucking business. But we've seen this. And CM Punk is really good. But come on, Ryback can't sell shit. He's really horrible at his job sometimes. So, I could, honestly, though, to continue the feud, I could see Ryback winning. But at the same time, I'm just like, I don't give a fuck who wins this match. Because I'm not interested in this feud anymore. I'm just not.
I think they should have done this feud last year over the WWE title. It would have been better. Because you remember this is around the same time that they fought for the WWE title this time last year. It's pretty much the same thing as last year, except not for the WWE title. It's not in the cell. That's the only two things that you're missing. But yet Paul Heyman is involved. It's just the shoe is on the other foot.
It's like this.
I'd rather go watch Passion of the Crisis 6 hours in a row than probably see that damn match.
Oh,
and
shit.
You know how long Passion of the Crisis is. That movie is 3 hours long.
You mentioned it twice.
That caused me to do a lot of drinking.
Dear Lord. But who do you got there? The Punk or Ryback?
I'm gonna go with gouge my eyes out, please. I think the only reason why this match will be good is only because Punk is wrestling. And I'm not saying it because I'm a Punk fan and I got a, you know, Pepsi logo because of CM Punk. But it's just because, like, he's going to put the wrestling in there, so it's pretty much, oh, I don't know, God. Too much thinking involved. It's going to make my head hurt. Oh, yeah, don't forget about this, too, though. This is probably, like, irrelevant and probably has nothing to do with it, but they're going to have Wade Bryant versus Kofi Kingston at Battleground. I just thought I'd throw that in there.
And I like both of those guys, but I don't think none of the fans give a shit about it. Big Red, who do you got, Punk or Ryback?
I hope Punk. I can't stand Ryback.
Well, I can't believe I'm saying this. I'm taking the right bitch only because of the fact that I think Paul Heyman's going to do something fishy with Curtis Axel. But we got to see these two face off again at Hell in a Cell and a Hell in a Cell match. This whole pay per view is looking like to be a shit card. Next, probably one of the only two matches that they've been plugging, and I say plugging because that would be me being polite. The Rhodes family taking on the Shield. Now, of course, remember if the Rhodes family wins, I think Cody and Goldust both get their jobs back. If the Shield wins, bye-bye. Yeah, I think we can all agree who's going to win in this match, but just to see if I'm wrong. Big Red, who do you got in this one? I'll start off with you first.
Man, you know what the fucked up thing is? We already know the spoiler for this because it's already fucked up.
What's the spoiler?
Yeah, I haven't read the spoiler list. Don't tell us.
Doug, you know about that because you had said something about that. In WCC, remember when somebody posted a picture of JBL becoming the new general manager over at NXT?
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah, I kind of went off on that person. Yeah, but that episode's aired now, so... So you're going to say the Shield wins?
Yep.
Because remember, Dusty's job as NXT trainer is on the line, not commissioner, because he is the trainer, which is weird. But
I thought he was just the commissioner over there. I didn't know he was training.
Yeah, he's the trainer over over on the Florida.
Well, he's over there as training. He can't get in the ring and do shit.
No. He's like the scouting or talent or something like that. Talent development. He's the talent development at the Florida blah 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 center or whatever.
Yeah. So you're still taking the shit after hearing all that, Big Red? Or you're staying? Are you going to change your pick?
Well, if it's just that, well, you know what? I figure, man, I'm gonna go with the road then because.
But you gotta think about it though. But wait,
it'd be them getting
their
job back.
But you gotta think about it though. It's kayfabe, so you know they really have a job. So they probably gonna like pull some bullshit, like okay, they're gonna you know lose or whatever, and probably win it at you know some I don't know. It depends on if Cody's is back from Cody is back from his honeymoon or whatever.
Yeah, he's officially back from the honeymoon with his wife.
So he probably I don't know.
You don't have a pick then? Oh, that's interesting. That might not be the first time we hear
that
tonight.
I guess it depends on how they want to go with it because they still have well. They have to win this time around. The Rhodes will have to win because I know damn well in the Hell in a Cell it'll probably be the Usos getting the tag team titles.
All right, so Doug, you've seen my video, and you know I don't explain to you, but I will explain to the people, probably to the entire IWC who's brain dead right now and being a little dumb fucks. Okay, so let me hit you guys with a fucking reality check. All right. So, the Rhodes family, the main stipulation is, if it didn't have the stipulation that I did, I would have a different answer. But the stipulation is, if Dustin, a.k.a. Goldust, and Cody lose this match, all their careers are kapoof. They can't go back to the WWE. And based on that thing, do you really think that they're going to lose this? This is going to be something that's momentous, and they're probably going to come out with the win. Yes, of course, if they lose, they'll probably end up doing some backstage shit. But the thing is, the stakes are really high, and when stakes are really high, they win. Or if you're John Cena's case and you're supposed to be fired or something like that, you still come back. But I firmly believe that they're going to win this match. If we didn't have that stipulation, I would pick the Shield any fucking day. But hey. Got to look at the fucking reality and the actual fucking facts. There you go.
Damn. So we got two for Rhodes, one who's undecided to go, you know, and I definitely understand that because I know there's a lot of fans who are having trouble with this match, but I'm going to take the Rhodes family as well, but I'm going to go a different route here. I think they win by disqualification and incorporate these. And then the next night on Raw, which will probably make fans want to throw money back in Battleground most likely, that he's going to say the match is a no contest and we're going to have a rematch at Hell in a Cell because I felt like this should have been done at Hell in a Cell or Survivor Series to start with. Because to be honest, I think it's going to be Rhodes 1-8-Q, not just hold up, no contest. Later on night on Raw, the Shield lose the tag team belts to the Usos. That's the way I see it going. But again, that's just my opinion. But you can tell we're just so excited for this pay-per-view, can't you, folks?
Woo! You can just feel the fucking excitement through all the cursing and the bitching and complaining. Yeah, we're all excited.
Speaking of bitching and complaining, we have a world title match. Alberto Del Rio taking on RVD in a hardcore match. I'm just going to say it. I don't think neither one of these guys is walking out as champion. My pick is Damian Sandow walking out as war champion.
All right, so I'm going to say this right off the bat because this is how it was the last time we did this. Everyone picked RVD to win, but only because something bad would happen. But and my bottom line is, okay, if you haven't read the spoilers or heard anything, sorry. And if you don't want to hear spoilers, get out of the fucking call or stop listening because I am going to say it. God damn it, I will.
I can't leave. Don't do it, Kayla.
There are rumors that RVD is going to be leaving because, I don't know, his little run is going to be ending, and there's a turn of events. So, based on that knowledge, whether it's true or not, that doesn't change my opinion. RVD is going to either lose this match, or if he does win, there will be a standout cash-in. My thing is, and I said it in my video, I'm sorry, RVD. There are tons of people in the back that deserve that chance more than you do. Yes, you're, you know, this big superstar, and you've had a lot of history with the WWE, but you're kind of more freshly new back still, even though it's been months. There are still people that deserve it more than you. I'm sorry. Sorry, I just can't picture him winning. I just can't.
So what? So yeah. What? His partial stats for the kick in now.
Yep.
You know, RVD, man, you got to take time off so he can go to that marijuana camp in Australia.
I guess he'd take a couple months off that way. He could smoke a weed for a month and then have a month for it to clear out his system.
Yep, and then he'll come back to the Rumble and do something stupid. But since it's just the three of us, now we can concentrate on probably the worst match of Battleground this week. And WWE title, Daniel Bryan versus Randy Orton. Tara, let's start with you.
First off, I just want to say I actually do like the heel Orton. The thing is, and you know, I'm not a Daniel Bryan fan. He's great in the ring, but I'm not a fan. The thing is, you know, he had that whole title stripped from him because of a fucking fast count. Okay, dipshits, refs, fucking in power. Okay, you guys are corrupt. All right, just because there's a fucking fast count and there always is a fast count, but because it's Daniel Bryan, you have to recognize it. And they're like, oh, we're going to strip this title. The good thing is they didn't put it right on right back on to Randy Orton. And the bad thing is, for 2 weeks, we were stuck without a WWE champion. And I personally don't think that's even good of company. WWE, that belt is the main belt of the goddamn company, and you don't even have someone holding that belt. That doesn't say a lot. But as far as the match goes, I predicted Daniel Bryan winning, and that's not changing. But the thing is, I just can't get into that goddamn match. I would rather watch the way... Kofi Kingston picking on Bray Wyatt. Okay, that is the bottom line.
Big Red?
I'm going to go with Daniel Bryan.
Why?
I'm tired of him. I'm tired of watching him get his ass kicked.
You know what? I said it in my video. I'm going to say it here. I don't think nobody wins.
But, okay, I say this, though. You have to have been prepared for the for all these RVD and, I mean, not RVD, but Randy Orton and Daniel Bryan match. Look how they was look at, like, most majority of May and stuff like that. It was pretty much a preparation to get you, you know, to see if these two could work together.
I think the only reason I'm not picking a winner, I think it's not going to be a winner, because think about it. If you want this feud to end, if you're working in WWE, would you want it to end a Battleground or Hell in a Cell?
I would actually try to carry it over until Survivor Series, as long as possible.
Well, I'm going to say the only reason I'm saying bad end because I'm like, okay, there's going to be some kind of bullshit dusty finish. Either somebody gets cheated, somebody gets screwed, or both get counted out or double DQ'd, and Remember when Edge and Undertaker faced off for the world title a few years back and Vicky kept stripping and the Undertaker of the belt?
Yes. My God.
This is what I think is going to happen here. I think until Orton wins it back, I think either Daniel Bryan will get stripped of it again, or they'll say, like, let's say Bryan wins with the yes lock or the no lock, whatever you want to call it. Next night on Raw, we hear, oh, I'm vacating the title because last night, because of some weird rule, because it was October, whatever, and the moon was full and everybody was wearing red, the yes lock was banned for that night. So, I say we'll find out who the WWE champion is at Hell in a Cell. Just my opinion.
Well spoken.
That's it, everybody. That's it for Battlegrounds. I don't really care for this pay-per-view. To be honest, I'm probably going to be watching the two Sunday night football games. So, yeah.
I'm probably with you there. Most likely.
In Big Red?
Man, fuck Battleground.
So I think we can all say it. Battleground's going to be a one-and-done pay-per-view like Capital Punishment.
Yep.
All right, well, God damn it. Everyone, if you don't know this channel, it's Spawn20113, and you could also catch us over on DXR420 on YouTube, still. And you can follow us on Twitter at WCC Live. I guess you should get Facebook out of the way. It's important. You go to facebook.com/group/commentary central. That's where you can find a large majority of us. Well, all of us. And you can find me personally on Twitter at HeelYTJFan. I just basically talk about a bunch of face off. So. And you can also find me on Facebook. Just look for a girl with a half-shaved head, pink, red, whatever the fuck you want to call my hair. It's a wild color.
Just look for the rainbow-haired Jeff Hardy. That's a woman. That's what
you
look like, Jeff
Hardy.
That's very
offensive, actually. Thank you, though.
You said what?
That's very offensive, but thank you anyway.
I won't say you look like a man. I just said, like, the hair was... hair-wise, you know, just look for, you know,
mm-hmm.
a lady that has this very cool Jeff Hardy hairstyle. I like Jeff Hardy.
And also, everybody, you can find me on YouTube. I've been a little more active since I just uploaded a video here, what was it, a couple days ago or so, a day, whatever. It was early in the morning. You can find me at OXO, Emo Kitty Cat. That is EmoKittyKatt. Forgive me, it's a long username, but I've had it for like 8 years. So there you go. Where can we find you, Doug?
Carol, can you repeat that again? I didn't catch all of that. You got to go slow on that. Slowly next
time. She said Emo Kitty Cat. Ooh, you've been a bad girl.
You know what? You know what? I will put it in the. I'll send Chris the fucking information because this is ridiculous. Otherwise, you can ask Doug Bear where to find me because he knows my shit. Now,
yeah,
Doug, where can we find you?
You can't find me on Twitter, so thank you, Oakland Raiders. You can find me on Facebook. Just look for the M. Bison giving you the thumbs down because, well, I like the villains, and if anyone asks me who M. Bison is again, I'm going to go find where you live and smack you upside the head with a coconut.
Coconuts make you crazy.
Yes, they do. You can also find me at YouTube at Doug Barrett 619 Part 2. It's my second channel because my first channel got shut down again. Thank you, Oakland Raiders, you dumb sons of bitches. Other than that, that's pretty much it.
Where can we find you, Red?
Well, you can find me on Twitter at... was that Redon81? Is REDDON81? Find me on Facebook too. Also, you can hit up my TNA recipe like page.
Mm-hmm. right, T5, where can we find you?
I think he's gone.
I think he left.
Oh.
I know we completely ignored you tonight, man, but...
All right. Okay, so obviously you can catch us here every Friday, 30 minutes after SmackDown. Well, we try on the main event, and then I will carry over to Doug because he knows all this shit.
All right, of course on... Oh, wait, I'm going over the shows. That's right. Of course, on Mondays we have WWE Raw Uncensored, which is hosted by Chris and Mr. Rock and Reese. On Tuesdays we have Overload, where, well, we usually talk a little bit of what happened on Monday night, just in case you missed our Monday night show. And then, of course, with Face Off. If you joined us this past week on Face Off, I do not apologize for offending anybody. On Wednesdays we have Ring Rockers with Rock and Reese and Sex Battles, which apparently I heard is supposed to be some show about puppets, because I never heard of Sex Battles before, so someone's going to have to fill me in on that. And, of course, Gator. I'm not Gator. Gator doesn't exist. Big Red, you're the one who does TNA recipes, so what is that?
TNA recipes, where we talk about stupid shit TNA doing right now. That's all I could just write out, so I could really put it honestly right now.
Well,
fuck
then,
you, Dixie Carter. Fuck you. Fuck you and your train.
Send hate mail at Dixie Carter on Twitter, because, you know, she doesn't ask Dixie. Just spam her with a bunch of hate questions. Thank you, and good night, WCC.
Yep. See you next.
All right, everybody got to hang up at once. And, you know, once, just call back in.
Bye-bye.
Be back. I'm not driven back.